gone through the story before us, and they've arrived at their, maybe not glory, but they're up there. And you know what? It's made it easier for us to just walk right in. We don't know. We don't know the stories that they've had and that they fought. But Sister Alice is going to go ahead and share.
Each one of you that are here. I know many of you know me since the beginning. Our pastors, Sister Diaz and her husband, Pastor Diaz Sr. was my first pastor, and then our pastor and Sister Margaret. And it is about the testimony of the Lord, not really me, not really you. It's a testimony of what God has done in our lives. And it's a privilege to be here. I really am glad. I was looking forward. I was a little nervous when Sister Yolanda, you told me, you know, I always was like that. Sister Diaz goes and Sister Lita. I get nervous, you know. But you know what? God is on my side. God is on my side. Who can be against me? And I just want to share with you. I'm going to give a little bit of my testimonies that some of you don't know about my, not my testimony, the testimony that the Lord gave.
Yes.
You know, and I wrote some things. I was going through some things. Lord, what do you want me to share? You know, the victories that God gives us, you know, He gives us victories. And it's for somebody else that's going through the same thing or is going to go through those trials and tribulations that it will help you. And I put my journey with the Lord. It's going to take a little bit, nomás. Dice, you know, I was a Catholic, and I was born a Catholic, and served as a Catholic until, you know, I came to Rock of Ages, and the Lord did save me. And, you know, my first scripture is John 14:6, where Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And that really touched my life because, you know, in some churches, they believe in worshiping idols, you know, and believing in this and that. And I would question myself, Lord, if you're the way, how come the other ones are the way too? So I got mixed up, you know, and I started praying. I actually went to pray in the bathroom. That was the only place that was quiet for me. I went to pray in the bathroom. I would sit down on the floor. At that time, I would sit down. And I asked the Lord, and He said, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So I started praying. And pretty soon, I told my husband, you know, and then I know some of you know Sister Andrade. They used to come here. And she invited me to Rock of Ages ministry. And then I said, okay, when I have a weekend off, I'm going to go. So I did. And I came here, and I just came to visit. It was on a Sunday, of course. And I like this church. And you know what? I felt, I'm going to tell you that some of you, if you don't feel, if you feel that you are the right church, that means you're right at the right church. You feel like in your family. You feel like you are in the family, not only your family, the family of God. And so that's the way I felt. And I was working in the hospital, and some of you know this story, but I was working in the hospital as a hospital bra. I love to clean. But anyway, I was working there, and once, I think it was a Thursday night, I was working at evening between 3 and 11:30 at night. And I was going through the hall, and all of a sudden I saw Pastor Diaz and Sister Diaz coming through the hall. And I said, oh, there comes the pastors. You know, that was the only time I had seen them. And they said the same thing. There comes our sister, they went to church. and we met in the hall. So I said, they said, God bless you. And I said, God bless you. And all of a sudden, without nobody telling me, I just said, you know, Pastor Diaz, very boldly, I told him, you know what, Pastor Diaz, I belong in your church. He goes, you do? You know? And I said, yes, I belong. And the first Sunday that I get off, I'm going to go to your church. And says it, hermano, I belong to your church. Been tribulations, a lot of trials, and a lot of things. But you know what? When you know without a shadow of a doubt where you belong, there's no question. There's no, I mean, the devil cannot move you. The devil cannot move you. So anyway, That episode, I was here as, like, I remember, like my sister Yolanda and brother David, I work alongside with Sister Diaz and Brother Diaz. And then came Sister Anita. Mm-hmm. And we work with them. And it was a pleasure. And at that time, I was thinking today, it was not that we went to class for deacons or went to class for this. They put me, como dicen, like they say, training on the job. Yeah. You are good to work and you're trained. But you know what? I get had good examples.
Yes.
I get had very yes. good examples.
Amen.
And Brother Diaz was very stern.
Amen.
He was a man, very stern, but you know, he knew what he was doing.
Yep.
He was called of God. And he would train you, he would tell you, and me, like I just, hermanos, it's not something that I want to brag about, but I brag about God.
Yes.
I fell in love with Jesus.
Yes.
I really did. He was like something that was, when I got saved and attended revival, and I even told my husband at that time, I told him, viejo, I got saved. This is what I was looking for, and you and nobody will take it away from me. I was so bold, and I told him, you or nobody's going to take it away. Because this is what I was waiting for. I was very troubled. I was a child. You know, I'm going to tell you. I was molested when I was a child. And that was, and I like what Sister Yolanda said about, you know, things that happened in the past, you know, we have to pray. Sometimes we fall in love with Jesus and we don't think about anything. And then the Lord, as you go in the journey, he deals with you.
Yes.
And you don't, sometimes you don't pay attention. Mm-hmm. That's why some things come, it's better to talk about in the family.
Amen.
You talk about, you know, with the people of the church that you trust. It's better to talk about it. Anyway, and then, so I began my journey with the Lord and everything. So, Pastor Diaz, you know, he told me one time, Sister Diaz, I'm going to talk to you. Mm-hmm. And that's when a year or 2 years later, he asked me that he wanted me to be a deaconess. I said, deaconess? But Brother Diaz, my children are not saved. See, I already excuse. My children are not saved. They're all lost. She said, it's not about the children, it's about you. And I said, okay, Brother Diaz, okay. Yes. I was so green that I didn't know nothing. I really didn't know nothing. And so I just obeyed. I just followed the man of God and the woman of God, and that's all I did.
Yes.
Maybe I fixed my eyes on the man or the woman of God, but I did.
Yes.
Well, anyway, and I served there. Then came the women's ministry. They came and told me that the Lord was calling me, that if I wanted to be a women's ministry president. So I said, yeah. So in Manasa, I served the women's ministry, I think 25 years until I had a stroke. And at that time, hermana, you know, that's why it's very important, hermana, to take care of deals first, family issues with yourself. Please pray and talk about it to somebody confident, you know. And when I see that area there, I don't like it at all. I like this better.
Yes.
And with the Lord, it's better, you know, because there's an answer.
Yes.
There's power.
Yes.
There's life.
Yes.
And that's what I pray, hermano, like I never prayed this week. And I love it because, you know, I can relate on some of those battles. And this scripture that Sister Yolanda, the Lord put in her heart, and I'm pretty sure it was a pastor too, because we were needed by a pastor. And more than ever, follow the men and women of God.
Yes.
Because the Lord has put them there.
Yes.
They are not put themselves there, believe me.
Yes.
When a man or a woman are put there by the Lord, they don't give up. I don't care what hell, what demon, what comes against you. You don't give up. And I can say this about my first pastor. I can say this about my second pastor. You know, you can see them. You can see them not struggling. But things have come against them, against like me, you know, they're human like we are. But they don't give up.
Amen.
They don't give up, and that's what keeps a church going.
Amen.
So praise God, hallelujah. So anyway, then my second episode of life came in 2004 when I had a stroke. And I was a woman, and here's my witnesses, especially Sister Diaz, Sister Anita, Sister Margaret, the boy. You know, Rachel, that I was a go-getter. I was.
Amen.
And everything, you know, I had to do for the Lord and everything, and the house and everything, at work and everything, like going and coming and going, taking aspirin to relieve the pain or whatever. But they told me I had high blood pressure. And I really didn't take care of myself. I didn't. And then the stroke came in 2004. And como le puse aquí, I really had to depend on the Lord. But I had a good husband. At that time, I had a good husband that would help me, understand me. He was a very quiet man. He was a patient man. I was the one that was always on the run. But anyway, he helped me. My husband helped me, family, church, friends. And so I had to find my strength on the Lord. I had to depend on the Lord.
Yes. Amen.
My friends, of course, my family, my friends, and everything. And like I put here, sometimes fearful. You know, and I'm going to tell what Sister Brenda said about, you know, anxiety attacks. I used to have those things, those two. And you know what it is? It's just fear. Fear from the enemy.
Amen.
He proposes that in your mind that you're going to die. That Rachel knows about it. You're going to die and this and that. Let me tell you one thing. One time I called Brother Diaz and Sister Diaz, and it was about 1 o'clock in the morning. I don't know if you remember, Sister. But I called all my children, and I told them that I was going to die. I was really afraid that I was going to die. I want to talk to everybody. And Pastor Diaz went at the Sister Diaz went at that time, you know, because I really felt that I was going to die. The lying devil, you know, it's 2017. I'm still here.
Yes.
So anyway,
so
I really had to depend on the Lord, hermanos. I really was paralyzed. Half of me was dead. On the right side, still dead, but you know, I have feelings.
Yes.
But anyways, I had to depend on the Lord. So I got in the hospital therapy for 4 weeks, and I went home in a wheelchair, and I couldn't see myself in a wheelchair. I was alone. I didn't have nobody to take care of me. My daughters were, you know, they had to work. They live in Phoenix, Norma and Rosemary, and my sons tampoco. So anyway, I was left alone. My husband would go to work. The yard, and I was left alone in a wheelchair, and then that's when the battle began on my mind.
Amen.
Here you are, a woman of God, and look what you are in a wheelchair. And I began that really that this was hard. It was hard. I couldn't accept it. But finally, I got a caregiver that started helping me, and then my husband, and he would help me after work and everything. So, so everything went. You know, I mean, it was very hard. And let me tell you one thing. I can remember just one time that I was crying, that my husband was helping me with a shower, and I was crying. It was Sunday morning, and I was crying, and I said, I don't want to go to church. And I was mad at maybe at God and maybe at myself for not taking care of myself. I really got mad. I said, I don't want to go to church. Why do I have to go to church? I feel terrible. I'm no good for nothing and everything. I just, you know, pound myself. And so my husband didn't say anything. He just helped me, and God bless. Finally, I came to church. And at that time, Sister Mary was here. And I guess Sister Mary noticed me. And then I was just crying and crying. I didn't even listen. I don't know what word came, but I didn't listen. So finally, when I went to the van, Sister Mary followed me. And she says, Sister Arias, what's wrong with me? I said, nothing is wrong. You know, when you lie to yourself, nothing is wrong. When everybody shows, you can see everything in your face, that something is wrong, you know. But anyway, that was, I think, the only time that I said, I don't want to go to church. Well, anyway, well, time passed and everything, and I'm getting tired already. But anyway, the other tragedy that came to our lives, but sometimes, hermanos, it's because we don't take care of ourselves. We don't hit to the voice of God. Sometimes we think that it's just man that is talking, but it's God.
Hallelujah.
Talking through the pastor,
yes.
You know?
Yes.
And I had an abusive, son. And with some of you, I don't know if you know, but my son stabbed my husband, and he killed him. 2012. So like I needed another tragedy in my life. And I remember very well, that day on a Tuesday, we were at Brother Sim and Sister Alex's house. We had a prayer meeting there. And me acuerdo que el pastor, told me, Sister Dia, or Sister Arias, don't be a prisoner in your own house.
No, that's right.
And that's all I can remember. He has said other things, but really I can't remember. But one thing that he told me, Sister Arias, don't be a prisoner in your own house. Mm. So what I did next day, there was a Tuesday. Wednesday, I anointed the house, I prayed, and that happened Thursday. Mm. I never said nothing to the kids, really, that Albert was just abusing my husband and me. And but when fear grabs your hermanos, that's what I say. You have to stand against that enemy.
Yes.
Because it's, como dice, the battle is not yours, it's not yours.
Yes.
Sometimes we want to handle that battle. We cannot stand with the enemy by ourselves. And so there was another blow to my life. But thanks be to God, I can be standing here.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
I tell you,
amen,
this victory in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Not only I stood the battle, my family with me, it was very hard. And I don't know if you remember, Rosemary remembers that week, the following week, because it took about a week for him to get there, prepare him and everything. And now I can talk. And I know the Lord is healing me.
Yes.
Because other things,
yes,
you know, before I could cry and cry and cry and cry, you know. And when I talked to my children, I remember I told them, you guys lift up your heads. Don't let this or anything that the enemy has come against you and me. We are more than conquerors.
Yes.
He's a lifter of our heads.
Hallelujah.
And he is really the lifter of our heads. Don't let anything, because let me go a little bit back and I'll be finished. When this something happened to me, I was very like ashamed of myself, like you blame yourself that things happen to you because it's you're to blame, you know. And I said no. When I find out about Psalm 139, where the Lord says, I'm fearfully and wonderfully made.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
That hit me like John 14:6, where Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And I said, no, I'm fearfully and wonderfully. That word, I have stood in that word, and that word has brought life to my life, you know.
Yes.
And so I continue that, you know, that I'm fearfully and wonderfully made.
Yes.
Because when I had the stroke, it was so difficult. I didn't look myself healthy. I didn't look myself as a woman. I didn't look myself as a mother, as a wife. It was so different. But thanks be to God.
Amen.
And you know, like I tell that the stars, when we have a group, that is not us. I don't care if we're weak, if we're this or we're that. The Holy Spirit is a sound mind.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit is love.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit, he's the one we're following the Lord. He helped us to follow the Lord. And so now I can say with all my heart and all of you, with my head lifted up to the Lord, because he is my lifter of my head.
Amen.
And I thank the Lord. And then another thing happened when Rosemary lost her eyesight. Maybe I'm still, you know, on that. That she became one eye blind, but you know what? Now she doesn't, you know, she quit her job and everything. But you know what? We're trusting in the Lord.
Amen.
And,
yeah.
And I don't feel nervous.
Yes.
And we have to pay bills and nothing is left. But you know what? I know God is our source.
Yes.
God is our source.
Yes.
And he is a supplier. But I always think that, you know, como dice que the silver and gold are mine. You know, that's what the Lord says. And he had never seen the spices forsaken, nor his descendants begging for bread.
Amen.
And no matter what you're going through, if you're young, you're old, you're middle-aged, lo que sea, pray, pray, pray.
Amen.
I mean, that's the, like I saw it yesterday, like when you're preparing ingredients, and the ones that are very good cooks, so I never was a very good cook, or a baker, you know, you have to get the ingredients ingredients together. And like the when you get a spoon, you have to stir all the ingredients together. That's the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit stir you. Let the Holy Spirit go so that batch can become, you know, a good batch for the Lord to use, a good vessel. And now you have the Holy Spirit. We have the Holy Spirit. We're now a temple.
Yes.
We're not just anybody.
Amen.
We hold the presence of God.
Yes.
If you only knew, I didn't know this. If you only knew who you hold the presence of God in you.
Amen.
You respect more. You take time for the Lord. Not let life run you. You take time for the Lord. So God bless you all, Sister Yolanda, Sister Margaret, that said, my God, I'm going to present myself. There were good leaders, were good teachers.
Amen.
There are good teachers here.
Amen.
Very good teachers.
Amen.
And I praise God for the praise team.
Yes.
And for the teachers, Brother Santos and Sister Margaret, with more respect, hermana, with more respect, because I can see that you stand. She is really on fire for the Lord. Hermana has put up the grounds, her grounds, and I praise God for that.
Hallelujah.
And I thank you for the new testimony, Sister Rachel and brother. Congratulations. Praise God. Hermana, let's go forward for the Lord and serve the Lord with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul.
Yes.
Even young people, children, don't let go of the Lord. Don't let go of the Lord. If the Lord has placed you here, stay here.
Yes.
Or if he has told you loud and clear, go to another place, like he told me. I was not to stay there in the Catholic Church. Mm-hmm. You know, he told me, go, and pretty soon Sister Andrade invited me, and here I am.
God bless you. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Same fire. So we'll go ahead and go forward and pray.